Thank you very much. We'll see you in a few minutes.
Welcome back to Underground Pulse, undergroundpulse.net. I am Jerica J.
And I'm Chilly.
And we're chilling here at Rocklahoma 2014 with nothing other but Rick from Adelitas Way. Say hi.
How are you?
I'm doing great, man. How are you? Staying cool?
I feel great.
Oh, man. It's so great to see you.
It feels good to be back. You know, we've been off for a minute and took some time off. I had a little girl. I had a little angel.
Aww.
And I made a record. So I had two babies in 1 year. You know, I had my daughter and then I had my album, which I worked extremely hard on for a year, you know, just constantly jamming and writing and practicing and playing. And it feels great to be back out here, and I feel like, you know, we're just getting the engine revving to come out and really stake our claim in where I believe we should be in today's rock scene.
Absolutely. And speaking of the new album, Stuck, Dog on a Leash, dude. Wow. Oh,
thank you.
I love that song.
Thank you, guys. Wait till you hear the album.
I'm
Wait to hear the whole record.
Looking forward.
The record is mean. We made a mean album. We made a different album, you know, I know some people are probably going to say, oh, you know, they changed their sound, all this and everything, and that's not what happens. It's, as a band, you got to evolve. You know, you got to continue to pay your homage to the people who came before you, the artists. I love music. Mm-hmm. I listen to bands just like everyone else does. You know what I mean? And I'm just trying to get across the influence that I have and through my lyrics and melodies, and also through the bands that I grew up listening to, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Which is all rock and roll, man.
Absolutely. How does the new album Stuck gonna be different from the last
album? It's an evolution. We've evolved, you know what I mean? It's like you know, for me, I wrote the first album, I wrote the second album, and I wrote the third album, and I wrote it with the guys, you know what I mean? And you know, me and Trevor have been a part of every album we've ever created, and now we have the addition of Rob, a guitar. Rob's been playing guitar with us for 3 years now, the past 3 years. Mm-hmm. And I think we have a great chemistry as far as writing, and I also think I was the best I ever have been. You know what I mean? I really came into this record cycle with a chip on my shoulder because I hear so many negative things about rock and roll, and I know that it's up to the bands to come out and make records that talk for us, and I wanted to make a record that talked for us. I wanted to make a record that, you know, at least rock and roll couldn't deny in my heart, you know what I mean? And I worked really, really hard on trying to just make a raw, real, organic-sounding record. Bass, drums, guitars, and vocals.
That's awesome. You did an interview with Loudwire recently.
Yes.
Talking about the album, about, you know, how you want it to last for decades.
Of course. I'm not trying to compete with whatever's going on right now, man. I'm not trying to compete with who's making records, whether it's Shinedown or Five Finger Death Punch, any, you know, those guys are doing their thing and I love them and that's great, but I'm not comparing my records that I create to them or their records that they're making. I'm not trying to compare it to what anybody did 2 years ago, 5 years ago. I want a record that sits in with time. You know what I mean? That sits in with all the records of time. You know what I mean? I'm not trying to just beat all these artists of today. I'm trying to settle myself in as an artist that's going to be here for a long, long time.
In the interview, you had mentioned that you wanted it to be as great as the Black Album from Metallica.
Well, I don't mean as great as the Black Album. I mean, that's how, you know, when you think of the record that defines Metallica, when you think of the moment where everything's, I mean, everything really came together, you think of the Black Album. You know what I mean? And we worked on this album endlessly to make a statement that we're here, that we're, you know, I feel like we're a little underrated, and I hate saying that because bands aren't supposed to say that about themselves, but when I come out of here, I feel it from all around, from other genres, from pop to alternative to, I mean, we're not getting enough respect, you know what I mean, and I know that we have more talent than the people who aren't giving us the respect, so we're coming to take it.
Good.
That's, you know, awesome. And that's the mentality we had. And honestly, we're going to continue that mentality and until the day I say I've said everything I have to say and I'm done making records. You know what I mean? And I don't think that's in the nearest of futures.
That's a great attitude to have.
Yeah.
And to be able to do all these things, you have your label,
Are you able to do more on your own, make your own decisions, or do they kind of try to push you?
Oh no, you know the label's involved. Look, it's a team effort, and you know I got to say we're one of the few bands left of this era that is still on a major label. You know what I mean? And I think there's some good to that and some bad to that, but yeah. I try to look at only the good. We have a great team who is working endlessly towards the same vision we're working towards. I want to be the biggest rock band in the world, hands down. Who doesn't want to be that? That's still what I'm striving for. I'm not making records just I want to reach everybody. I want everyone to hear the lyrics and the story that I'm telling. I'm not trying to just stop it at a certain, you know, music is for everyone.
Yep. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
So I like that we have, you know, that team, and our goal is the same. So I feel comfortable.
Yep.
But when it comes to making the record, it's like a marriage. It's like compromise. You know what I mean? And for every band it is. For Hailstorm, for Shinedown, for us, for 3 Days Grace. I mean, for every band that you have, everybody out there that reviews our albums, they don't understand that, of course, we would like to make some songs 10 minutes long. You know what I mean?
Right.
Of course,
yeah.
We'd like to do some things like that. But, you know, at the end of the day, making records comes down to compromise with you as an artist, as a team. You know, on our new album, there's about 9 songs on the record that we absolutely did every single thing we wanted to do.
Wow.
Every single thing, and the label didn't bother us, and they were just like, "You guys make your record." We jammed those songs in a jam room for 7 months together, and put everything we wanted to put in them, and they went on the record exactly how we wanted to record them.
That's awesome to know that your label supports you like that.
You know, and there was a couple songs that we still wrote, that I wrote, mm-hmm. that they were like, "We really love these songs, and this is." We think this should be a little more bare and a little more acoustic, a little more nice. Or they put their input in, and that's where the marriage becomes.
Gotcha.
You, as an artist, I can't just tell everybody. Am I allowed to curse on this show or
yes.
not?
Yes, please.
I can't just tell everybody in my path to fuck off. You know what I mean? That's career suicide. So I think you have to be willing to listen to grow. I like to listen, evaluate, and you know, see if there's room for myself to improve or not. And maybe sometimes other people are right, and I'm not always right. But for 9 songs, I was right on every piece of the music, so.
That's amazing. And I love that your guys' recorded sound, but to me personally, it's to see you live is where you win people over.
That's what we tried to capture on this record as much as possible. I mean, we really tried to capture what our live show brings to... You know, what our stage show brings is something special. I definitely, when was the last time you've seen us?
I saw you the first time, I think it was 2009 at Twisted Christmas in Kansas City.
So you haven't seen us in a minute.
No, I think you played at Rockfest before, though, after that, didn't you?
Yeah, but wait till you see where we're at now.
No.
I mean, the point it's at now, yeah, I feel like we're certainly one of the best live rock and roll bands that is playing today. I really, truly feel that. And we tried to convey that as much as we could on the record. And it's still, our live show is mean enough to where we still don't think it even came across the way we exactly wanted it to. But anybody that has any doubt, come out and check the show out. I'm very confident in it. You know, we can play. All of us. I can sing the songs the way they sound. The guitar player can play them the way they sound. Our drummer is one of the best drummers I've ever played with. So I'll challenge anybody to tell me. You know,
that we
can't play live. We practice, man. We're a band. You know what I mean? We play a lot. We play a couple hundred shows a year, and then we're not playing shows. We're still practicing or writing records or playing, or we never stop.
And people are going to have plenty of chances to come and see you guys. You guys are on a 2-year tour. Is that about right?
You know, we got a lot of touring booked, man. You know, here's the one thing I don't want. I never want anyone to take us for granted and feel like we're going to be around forever. You can't have that. You got to take every show... You know, and really appreciate it. You know what I'm saying? Because you don't know. And for us, I don't want it to be like, oh, we're gone for 2 years. We'll catch them sometime. Everyone's got to come out and check it out, man. It's a magical thing, man. I really feel it, you know? Because one day we're all going to look back at the times of our lives, and I want to be a part of a lot of people. So I go out with that mentality every time I perform, that I'm putting on something memorable for everyone, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And but yeah, we got about 2 years of touring. We've been blessed, man. A lot of people are making us great offers to come on the road with them. And we also got visions of headlining the entire United States and hopefully the world, you know what I mean? So it starts right now. We're out on tour doing the festivals. We're at Theory of a Dead Man. Then we do some dates with 3 Days Grace in July. Then in August, we got some dates coming up. I think we'll play some headlining shows. We got some other things in the works. September to November, we're out with the Pretty Reckless.
Nice.
Which will be awesome. And then in the new year, you know, we're hearing some rumblings of a possible, you know, just a possible amazing tour that we're looking at with some of our favorite bands that they've throw our, you know, they kind of reached out to us. And then in 2015, March, April, May, you got to look out. We want to tour the world. Headline.
Hell yeah, dude.
Yeah.
I got to ask, with you know, with the new baby and you being a dad, how does that affect your family life?
It motivates me more than anything, because every single day that I'm away from my daughter, I better make sure that I'm making the maximum value of the day. So before I perform, I look up, man. I say my prayers. I do what I do. You know, I really just ask for, you know, let me be me. Let me go do what I do. And I always think about my family before I go out, because I'll perform excellent, because I have to, you know, for myself. If I'm away from my daughter, I better be great. I better be being great. It better be for a cause that she can be proud of one day. You know, me making my spot in music.
It's very honorable.
Yeah.
Very. Did you have another question for him? Well, also back with the 2 years, how do you guys try to keep sane on the road? Do you have any things where you try to relax?
You can't let negativity destroy you, man. Honestly, if you want to stay sane on the road, you got to keep a positive attitude. You got to really just try to work through everything and realize that sometimes life is hard and there's a lot of ups and downs. And I mean, I obviously got to take my own advice sometimes. Sometimes I get bummed out when your motor blows up or something happens, you know. But at the end of the day, you know, you got to focus on the task at hand, which is playing music and bringing music to people all across the United States, because obviously no one else is helping us. You know, the mass media isn't helping us get our music out to people. So we got to play shows in front of people and surprise them every night.
Yeah.
Every night make them walk away like, how did I not know about this band? Why did I just find out about this band? That's what we're doing.
Yeah.
You know, and we smoke weed to relax. I mean, I'm going to be out where we're doing an interview. Yeah, we try to be. Our days off look like the days off of a 12-year-old. You know what I mean? It's like we smoke weed, we eat food, we watch movies. I just watched X-Men last night. You know, we got treat ourselves with a little ice cream or yogurt. You know what I mean? It's like we like to unwind, relax, man. I love massages. I like
who
to
doesn't?
Just, you know, it's there's a lot of things that'll keep you from going nuts. Yeah, definitely.
Speaking of movies, what movie are you really looking forward to this summer?
I just saw it, X-Men.
Just X-Men?
And
it was
amazing. It was the best one that I've seen.
It
was the best one that I've seen yet. And I cannot wait. If you're a fan of the series, man, it's the best one.
Great.
It's the best one.
We're really looking forward to seeing that.
Yeah, it's great.
Rick, thank you so much for coming in. Now, Stuck comes out next month?
July.
Yes.
July 29th. But everybody pre-order it now. You pre-order it now, you'll get the single you'll get Stuck. And you'll get Dog on a Leash. You'll get the title track to the record, right there. If you pre-order it, you get it right away.
Dude, I'm looking forward to it so much. Thank you so much for sitting down with us and talking to us. Real quick, can you say, hey, this is Rick from Adelitas Way, and you're listening to Underground Pulse?
Of course. Hey, this is Rick from Adelitas Way. You're listening to Underground Pulse.
Thank you so much, dude.
Thank you.
We'll see you soon.
Thank you guys.